वेलकम बैक डियर स्टूडेंट, स्वागत है आपका आपके अपने यूट्यूब चैनल पे। तो बच्चों, आज हम देखने वाले हैं चैप्टर नंबर 3 डिजिटल डॉक्यूमेंटेशन का सेशन नंबर 3, दैट इज टेक्स्ट एडिटिंग। एज यू ऑल नो दैट द डॉक्यूमेंट विच क्रिएटेड इन लिब्रे ऑफिस राइटर एप्लीकेशन इज एडिटेबल, एंड इफ वी आर सीइंग टेक्स्ट एडिटिंग सो वी शुड नो वॉट आर द थिंग्स आर देयर इन एडिटिंग। एक्चुअली एडिटिंग अ डॉक्यूमेंट इंक्लूड्स selecting, copying, pasting, moving and deleting the text. So these are the topics which we are going to see today, like selecting text, copy and paste text, then move the text, selection criteria, then selecting text in non-consecutive manner, then selecting a vertical block of text, then using final replace feature, then viewing non-printing character, then checking spelling in document and using synonyms and thesaurus. So let's start from selecting text. So I'm taking new document here. So this is one document where I have already created one document where I have already written sample text. So primary step in the process of editing a document is selecting the text. And the selection of text is known as also block marking. We can say selecting text is block marking. You can select the text in the word processing document by pointing a cursor before the text from where you want to select the text and dragging the mouse over the portion of the text for the selection. Means if I want to select this first text, sample text, so my pointer should be here and then I need to drag this pointer like that. This is selection. Okay, so we have covered our first point. We will highlight it. Okay, the next is copy and paste text. What is my copy? Actually, duplicating some text and placing it at some other place in the same document or in some other document is known as copying and pasting the text. Making duplicate copy. So this is our document, and as we already discussed that the editing basic step is selection. So now for every operation, for every process, first we need to select the things. Okay, so if you want to copy anything, for example, if you want to copy the things, so first we need to select it. I have selected. Then you can use the different thing. From here also you can copy. Otherwise, you can use this edit menu for copy. Otherwise, you can use Ctrl plus C. Otherwise, you can use right click and then copy. And you can select the location in your document where you want to paste it. As I am pasting here, you can use all the four ways for pasting the desired text. Okay, so we have covered this also, copy and paste text, done. Now the next thing is move the text. When you copy a portion of text and paste it to new place, it means you have pasted a copy of the text to the new place. However, moving the text is different from copying. Means when you copy the selected text, it is placed at new location. Means in move the text process will not get the duplicate copy. See now. This is our document and this is the result of copy. And if I want to show the result for move only, then the same text will copy. And now you can drag it anywhere. We have dragged that sample text here. Now you can see the change. It aligned automatically. That's why we are getting the space empty. Okay, you can see यू विल गेट हियर डायरेक्ट सी ओके मीन्स हियर वी आर नॉट गेटिंग द ओरिजिनल कॉपी एज इट इज वी आर मूविंग द टेक्स्ट सो द मूविंग द टेक्स्ट इज ऑल्सो डन सो विल हाईलाइट इट नाउ द नेक्स्ट थिंग इज सिलेक्शन क्राइटेरियम Beside proceeding ways of selecting the text, you can also select a word, sentence and paragraph as per your requirement in different ways. For example, you can select a single word, you can select a complete sentence or you can select a complete document in by using a different ways that we are going to see now. So we want a document. So this is our document. So the first condition for one word. If I want to select a single word, then what I should do? We can select a single word by first positioning the mouse pointer on that word and then double clicking. If I want to select this first sample word, then my mouse pointer is here and double click. We can see the result. Means we can say we can select the one word by using double click. Then if I want to select the complete sentence, for example, this is one sentence, and if I want to select this, then we need to click the left mouse button 3 times. You can see I'm pressing the left mouse button 3 times. 1, 2, 3. Okay, so we can write here 3 times. Now the third condition is that you can select a paragraph, complete paragraph in a document by placing the mouse pointer anywhere on a paragraph and clicking the left mouse button 4 times. For paragraph, now you see this is one paragraph. If I am placing my mouse pointer here anywhere in this paragraph and I'm pressing my mouse 4 times, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so you can see the complete paragraph is selected. So we can write here 4 time click. Okay, now the last one category for selection criteria is if you want to select the complete text written in a document. So in that case, you have to press one shortcut key, that is Control plus A. Now I am pressing the Control plus A from my keyboard and now you will see the result. Okay, so the complete text will selected in a document. So we can write here complete text for Control plus A. So here we have completed selection criteria also. So we'll highlight it. Now we need to see selecting a text in non-consecutive manner. Actually, the previous way to select the text is a continuous manner. However, you can also select the text in document in non-consecutive manner. You need to perform the some steps for that. For example, this is a okay. Now I want to select this one word, then double word, then 3 and 4, means numerous word I want to select. Then I select this one word. Then if I'm going for selecting the double word, then what will happen? It will deselect. So in that case, what we can do, you just select the first word and then press Control key from your keyboard. I'm pressing the Control key and now just select double, 3 and 4. In that way, you can select the word which are in non-consecutive manner. Got it. So we have completed this topic also, selecting a text in non-consecutive manner. Okay, we have highlighted. Now the next one is selecting a vertical block of text. So see, now I am selecting this, but after that if I want to select only this much part, if I want to select first half, then I can't use any process here. I can use the control key, but I don't want to use that control key here for selection. I want direct vertical block, selection of direct vertical block. So in that case, what I should do, you have to click on edit, then you have to click on selection mode, and then actually this is standard, horizontal selection means standard. So in that case you have to click on block area. Now you can easily select the block, vertical block we can say. Okay, so we will deselect it. So here we have completed selecting a vertical block of text topic. We have highlighted it. Now the next topic is using find and replace feature. Actually, the find and replace feature of LibreOffice Writer helps you to search a particular word, phrase, or sentence in your document. This feature is particularly useful in finding the desired text easily in large document. It also enables you to replace a word or phrase in your document at all its occurrence with another word or phrase. For example, if you have created one document which is of let's say 100 pages and you did the same mistake everywhere, so we need to find that mistake, or if we need to find that word which is not proper, and we need to replace this that word with a new one, proper word. So in that case you can use find and replace feature. For example, now the sample text is written. So many times I have used sample. I want to find the sample word in my document. I want to change that sample word with new one. So I'll write here given text. Okay, so in that case you need to click on edit menu. Then here you will get option for find and replace. This dialog box will open. The name of this dialog box is find and replace. Now see, find. So what we are finding? We are finding sample. One thing you should remind always, the word which you are finding and the word or spelling which we are writing in this text box, that should be same. The spelling should be same, then and only then it can find. And replace with what? We'll replace this word with given. Okay, then find all. We can see here the result. It found all and then replace all. Okay, then close it. You can see the result. All spelling of sample is converted into given. So this is use of find and replace feature. So here we have covered using find and replace option also. Now the next part is viewing non-printing character. Actually, there are number of character that get inserted in your document when you press the spacebar, enter key and tab key. But these characters are non-printing character as they get replaced by blank space only and do not appear on the print of your document. This feature is quite useful when you work with formatted document
and need to keep track of your tabs, spaces and blank line. So see, here in this paragraph, now we will use tab key also, space key also and enter key also. So in first line, we'll use tab key. After every word, I'm using tab key now. Okay. In second sentence, we'll use space key. And in third, we'll use enter button. So now we can say that we have used all the three tabs, means tab key, space key and enter key. Now we will see the non-printing character. If these spaces are not printable, then how can we keep the track of this tab, space and blank lines? So when toggle formatting mark is there, so this is toggle formatting mark. If we click on this, so you can see the things. You can see that this is toggle formatting mark. It is added in text document on pressing the enter key. And it looks similar to paragraph mark. Okay. Then the next one is space mark. So these dots are space mark, where we have used the space key. Then the last one is tab mark. In the first line, we press the tab key. So here we are getting a tab mark. It is added in text document on pressing tab key. And once you click the toggle formatting mark icon, all the non-printing character in your document are displayed. We are seeing now. Here also we have used enter button. Okay, so this is all about the non-printing characters. So we have covered this non-printing character also. Now the next one is checking spelling in document. Actually, LibreOffice Writer allows you to carry out automatic spelling and grammar check to correct language errors in document. For example, if I am writing something wrong in my document, so we'll close it first. Okay, here I am writing. I am creating. First document, you can see here I have written wrong spelling of first. The spelling of first is F-I-R-S-T and I have written here F-R-S-T. So you can see red wavy line is there. So we need to check it and we need to, means we will not do anything. Actually LibreOffice Writer will do. That is the feature of LibreOffice, checking spelling in document and automatic spell check. So how can we do it? We need to click on, first select it, then we need to click on tools tab from menu bar. Here you will get option for spelling, automatic spell checking, or you can click on spelling also. If we click on spelling, you will get this dialog box. The name of this dialog box is spelling. And you can see here the word, the sentence which consists of that word. I am creating first document. And these are some suggestions where we can choose the correct one. So this is our proper word, F-I-R-S-T. So we need to click on correct. The spell check is complete. Okay. And then close it. So we got the correct spelling. So here we have completed this checking spelling in document. So we are going to highlight it. Now the last part of this video is using synonyms and thesaurus. Suppose you are writing a paragraph and you need an appropriate word with similar meaning to a word that you have used in paragraph. So in this case, you can use thesaurus to find synonyms. Means a different word with the same meaning. So how? We will see. So let's say I have used one word, cursor, and I want to search the alternate word for cursor. So first select the word, then click on tools. Here you will get one option for thesaurus. Click on that, you will get one dialog box, and here alternatives are written. Pointer is a noun, and then indicator. These are the alternate words for cursor. You can use anything. Pointer, then replace. So desired word is replace. So here we have completed using synonyms and thesaurus both. So for today, we will stop here only. In next video, we will see formatting document. So ये वीडियो आपको कैसा लगा ये कमेंट बॉक्स में जरूर बताइए. लाइक एंड शेयर करना ना भूलिए. तब तक के लिए बाय बाय, टेक केयर एंड एंजॉय योर लर्निंग.